Cuisine Concepts. Visit us at cuisineconcepts.com. Add ease and elegance with quality custom accessories like grates and floorboards, cockpit tables, companionway doors, replacement windows, hatches, tables, and more. See a complete line of our products at cuisineconcepts.com.
Hi, my name is Joe and I own a 1977 Catalina 30 Mark I. Last fall, I removed all the windows because they were all leaking. Spent about 30 to 40 hours rebuilding them, put them back in the boat, only to find the first time I washed the boat, they were all still leaking. Little research on the web, and I found Cruising Concepts had a Catalina 30 retrofit kit for the windows. I ordered it, came boxed completely perfectly, had the installation kit, so I had the warranty and the installation instructions. Went up to my boat, installed it in about a day and a half. I have a boat that looks 30 years newer. I recorded the installation so that you could see how easy it is to install these windows. I'm so impressed with the product and how easy it was that I'm sure I'll be installing more things from Cruising Concepts. I hope you enjoy the video. So here we are. We're going to start the Catalina 30 window replacement. Per the instructions, we're going to remove the window and check the fascia. So I'll be removing these screws and then we'll check the fascia, make sure that it fits properly. Okay, window frame has been removed. Now we're going to make sure that the fascia fits. It does. Fascia fits in okay. So now we have to start cleaning the outside. All right, I use a soft scrub and a scrubby first, get the frame good and clear. Then I just used a clean rag and some water to wipe that all down, dried it with a nice dry cloth, and then I used acetone to clean it up. And the frame looks pretty good. So here's the frame, good and clean. Next thing I'm going to be doing is putting in the 1 1/4 tick marks so that I know where to place the window. All right, so we've got some small pencil marks now all the way around the frame so that I can put the window in and then trace the line. So that'll be next. Okay, so the duct tape facilitates holding the window in place if you're alone. The tick marks right here and down here all the way around the frame, I take the ruler and I just make sure that I have the same distance to all the tick marks, and that puts the window in place so that I can trace my line around it. Okay, got the line traced all the way around the frame. Now I'm going to verify that I have the 3/4 inch overlap. Make sure that I have ample space for the Dow Corning stuff, and I do. So the next thing will be to tape it up so that I have a nice clean surface once I'm done. To get the tape around the corners, what I'm doing is putting a little tape down, and then I'm drawing a line on it, and then cutting it out with a scissors, and that gives me a nice clean edge. You'll see when I have it all completely taped up that I don't have to worry about getting the Dow Corning anywhere. Okay, taping is done, and as you can see, we got because we cut it out, we got nice round edges. Goes all the way around the window. Up here we have paper towel ready to set the caulk down. I got the spreader ready. I've got duct tape ready for the window. So the next thing will be to put the caulk all the way around and then smear it to about 1/16 of an inch. At the same time, I'm going to prepare down here the window. I like to have the windows upside down so that when I pick them up, they're prepared to go right up onto the boat. So I'm going to remove this before I start caulking the outside. So once I get the outside caulked, I can come in here, lay my 1/8 inch bead at 1/2 inch all the way around the new window and stick it on and be ready to tape it and put sandbags in place. Okay, so I'm removing the backing here. I'm doing it with gloves so that I don't have any oily finger residue left on the glass. I also have the sandbags out here ready to go. And next we'll start putting on the Dow Corning. What I found worked well for me was putting two liberal eighth inch beads all the way around. And the next thing that I'm going to do is use the putty knife to flatten that out to a 16th of an inch all the way around the frame. Okay, it's been smeared now. You can see it's nice and flat all the way around the frame. Next thing will be to put the window caulk on. Okay, so the window's in place. I used the tape to hold the window up, and I used the sandbags to hold the window against the deck. So now I have the sandbags and the window in place. It looks like I have a good ooze coming out. All right, it was liberal, so let's go inside the boat, check what it looks like inside the boat. You can see I've got I got it coming in, so that means I have a good seal all the way around. One thing I'm going to do now is I'm going to come over here. I have a little egg timer. I'm going to set that egg timer to 1 hour, and then I'm going to continue to check to make sure that the sandbags haven't moved and the window is placed properly on the boat at 1 hour, and then I'll probably just check it every hour until I go to bed. So it's been several hours since the window's been put in place. I'm using a just a little plastic putty knife. What I find is if you drag it along the edge like this, and then you drag it along the edge like this very gently, the caulk comes off very. So here we are on the outside of the window. I just take the caulk, the putty knife, place it like this around the tape, and then this way, and you'll notice it comes right off. So